Excellency, the President of Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka, Mr. Gotabaya Rajapaksa, President and Members of Government Medical Officers Association, distinguished guests, my dear pre-intern medical officers, ladies and gentlemen, have a pleasant midday. It's a great pleasure to address you all, the pre-intern medical officers who are gathered here to participate in this Good Intern program organized by Government Medical Officers Association in collaboration with Ministry of Health for the 8th consecutive year. I was made to understand that Good Intern program was introduced after studying and identifying the knowledge and attitude gap between the medical students and intern house officers. Further, Good Intern program also address the other areas of needing improvements, such as communication skill, bilingual languages, as well as competency in performing essential clinical skills as an intern house officer. The topic given to me today is the role of Ministry of Health in Good Intern program, which is very clear and transparent. Firstly, I believe the main role of the Ministry of Health is organization and providing logistics to this program. While thanking GMOA for undertaking this responsibility now and during past, I believe Ministry of Health should shoulder more responsibility in this program in future. Secondly, funding of the program, which has been happening for last 7 years, and Ministry of Health will continue to fund this program. I would like to remind, or I would like to highlight of an important point for these budding doctors, which I have observed some of the young doctors and some of the senior doctors also have comfortably forgotten that. You were educated for 13 years in island-wide schools and further 5 years in medical schools by good teachers and university dons. For this, enormous amount of money was spent by the government, which was collected from taxpayers of Sri Lanka. Hence now, you are bound by debt to citizens of Sri Lanka to be an honorable doctor, to be a proud citizen. Each one of you have to pay this back to country, not by money, but by dedicated service towards the community. As mentioned earlier, as an intern house officer or intern medical officer, you will be the primary contact or first contact of a patient. You will be the bridge between the patient and consultant. An intern medical officer or intern house officer, you will be the glue between the nursing staff, minor staff, and senior medical staff in your ward. You should be able to identify or recognize their values, value of each of your team members, and also you should be able to respect each other. Your coordination at each of these levels will slowly loosen your bonds. Medical knowledge required to perform at this level is already stored in the hemispheres. Further learning will added while working. What matters next is presentability attitude, responsibility, accountability, and adherence to medical ethics. I have to say that proper dress code is a must. Modesty plays a very big part in this. Cultivation of good attitudes towards the staff, patients, and their relations will take you very far. Showing responsibility towards each and every patient and accountability of work performed in the ward will make you a good doctor. 35 years ago, when I started my internship, there were no workshops or programs like this. Letter of appointment came by post, and we reported to the respective hospitals as instructed. Senior house officers and consultants